hyperLativ,
the Norwegian gamer.
You need to get to the control. Hi guys, hyperLativ here, the Norwegian gamer. And this is some more alpha protocol. It's the game I'm playing for the time being, so just have to bear with me. I got a lot of content. This video is actually not going to be a gameplay commentary, which I've usually been doing for these clips. It's actually going to be some of my thoughts and impressions of the game, actually. As I mentioned in the first commentary that I did for this game, it was a game developed by Obsidian, published by Sega, and I thought that it was highly underrated and underappreciated. And the reason being that I know that it's not a perfect game, but it's something that we don't see too often. It's a spy RPG, which should be every action RPG's wet dream. I mean, who doesn't want to be a spy? And if you're not necessarily a hardcore RPG fans like Final Fantasy or something of that kind, but more the, you know, Mass Effect RPG guy who likes an action RPG or a shooter with some RPG elements in it, this should be the game for you guys. I mean, this is actually quite awesome. And I realize it's not perfect by any stretch of my imagination, but still, I think it's a really decent game, and it's been a lot of fun playing through. Of course, there's some strange things that happen from time to time, but it's nothing that I can't live through. And I know that one of the criticisms of the game was that it was kind of hard to tell when you're well hidden and when you're not. I mean, there's no indicator to tell you, am I now hidden from enemies or am I not? Or if I'm in this shadow, won't I be seen? And the fact is that it's only as long as you're not too close to an enemy, you won't be seen. Or as long as you're not you're in his, you know, line of sight kind of deal. So even if you're hiding in a shadow, he won't walk right past you like he does in Splinter Cell, for example. He will actually see you, and you will have to find a way to hide from his line of sight. That's the only way to actually hide. So I know that some people kind of think that's strange, but then again, it's just a game, so I don't know. And there's also no way to really tell if someone can hear you or not. So I guess the best way to move around is just by crouch walking like I do almost all the time. But all in all, I'm having more fun with this than I've had with any Splinter Cell game. And those are, you know, those are pretty hardcore stealth games though. So this isn't so that much hardcore, I guess. But it's pretty enjoyable, even though it has some flaws. And as I said, it's a spy RPG. It's not meant to be as hardcore as Splinter Cell or as chatty Metal Gear Solid. So it's a bit different, and I like it for it. And another thing that I should probably mention is that
got a present for you.
There's also kind of a dialogue mini game kind of deal that we first saw in Mass Effect, where you have four different options to choose from all the time, or not all the time, but you often have up to four different dialogue options when you talk to people. And one is professional, one is aggressive, one is suave, and one is rude, I guess. I don't know what the last one is, but you know. So yeah, you kind of have to decide what kind of dialogue option you're gonna go with. One of them is different persons like different approaches. So one person might like you to be to the point, I don't know what the expression is in English, but just dawdle about and don't get to the point. He might like that you just get to the point straight away and That's what makes him like you more. While other persons might prefer you to be more subtle, be more friendly, and other persons might prefer you to kind of, I don't know, kiss their ass, I guess? You know, kind of talk them up and, you know, take their side regardless of what you really think of them. And others like that you kind of, I don't know, stay secretive, I guess, and be very spy-like. And there's even some female interests that you can be quite flirtatious with, or playful with, actually. So, that's a whole other game in itself. And the interesting thing is that based on how persons like you, you'll get different bonuses or, how should I put it, different drawbacks by partnering up with them. So on each mission you usually have a handler, and that handler might give you some perks or features, or out of it, let's just call them perks, that you'll have through that mission, which will give you some which will have some outcome on something in the mission, like faster cooldown rates on your abilities, or more sound dampening, which makes you less audible and the enemies won't hear you as easily. So based on how that person likes you, that perk is different. So it might be better if they like you a lot, and it might actually hinder you if they don't like you at all. If they don't like you, they might make you have a harder time to actually complete the mission. So I think there's a lot in it, and I'm really enjoying the game right now, and it's really just opened up, and I can do pretty much whatever I want, and yeah, it's good. Of course, I also have to mention that there's a lot of different options when it comes to how to solve a mission. You can go all stealth or all the way to Rambo. So, yeah, you'll see the different options. I hope you enjoyed. Hope to see you next time. Snuck it!